Good afternoon, family, friends, staff, and graduates. Welcome to the graduation ceremony honoring the class of 2016. Thank you for sharing this special time with us. You may be seated. Thank you, Brianna and Javonta. Thank you for that wonderful welcome. At this time, I would like to recognize some special guests who are here in attendance. Please stand when I call your name. First, the Georgia School for the Deaf, class of 2016, please rise. Thank you, you may be seated. Now, GSD, faculty and staff. Thank you. Former GSD, faculty and staff. Former GSD graduates. Future GSD graduates. State of Georgia Board of Education, Mr. Larry Winter. Other Department of Education staff. And next, I would like Mr. Larry Winter to please come up to the dais and share a few comments.
Good afternoon. GSD is a very special place. I discovered it when I came here for the very first time 11 years ago. And there's one thing that all GSD graduates have in common. Courage. They are the most courageous people that I know. When I understand what they have to do to master science and other subjects that I, with hearing, take for granted, I am always humbled. And then I see the things that they do after they leave GSD, making great contributions to our state, to our country, to our world. And then we have that mild celebration each October. They call it homecoming. I call it the overpopulation of Cave Spring, because 3,000 to 5,000 graduates will come celebrate their experience and the experience of those that are going to GSD. So graduates, thank you for your courage, and God's blessings on you as you go forth from this place.
Now we now have the superintendent for the state of Georgia, Mr. Richard Woods, here today. Please come up.
Well, good afternoon. To the staff here and to the graduates, I wish to say congratulations. I think that for the staff, what I would say is that you are makers of excellence. And I appreciate the work that you have accomplished. Many hours, many struggles, but you have accomplished a lot. To our students, I believe you are excellent overcomers. The challenges that you have faced, the difficulties that you have overcome can be, I think it's just an inspiration for all. And that's why I think for both our teachers and to our students and graduates, I would gladly say that you are all givers of hope. You are individuals that inspire. You are individuals that have showed us all that nothing can be overcome. I think even last night, my wife, who is a diehard fan of Dances with the Stars, to see a young man, I think, by the name of Niall DeMarco, an individual who cannot hear at all, to do this and do what he did week after week was just an amazing feat. And I think that should be an inspiration for us all, to you as students, that, what I would say is that anything you aspire to achieve, you can. And so I wish to congratulate you. Thank you for your efforts. Thank you for the inspiration. Thank you for sharing your lives with us. And thank you for parents and guardians for giving these children, the opportunity to succeed. And so I wish you the very best in life. I wish you much success. And I look forward to hearing the many stories that you will write in the years ahead as you show that you can do anything and you continue to inspire us as adults of all ages. Thank you very much.
Now our top two students will come up and give their addresses. We have the valedictorian, Zacchaeus Walton, and the salutatorian, David Martinez. So David, please come up first.
First of all, congratulations to the class of 2016 here at GSD. I'd like to thank all the family, friends, faculty, and everyone who's here today with us. Thank you. I'd like to start out being thankful for what's brought me here today, the upbringing that I've had. There were friends at school who taught me a lot about sign language and helped me to grow here. I've really enjoyed my time here at the Georgia School for the Deaf. One of the reasons for that are the friends that I have and American Sign Language. Being here has helped my own sign language skills to grow and develop. The classes here have been rigorous and challenging, and I haven't given up. I've learned a lot here. The classes have helped to prepare me for post-secondary or college work. So I'd also like to say thank you to Chad Moore as my math teacher. I really love math. He's a great mathematician, as well as Mr. Corey Richardson, who taught me physical science, which also involves math, which I really like a lot. I enjoyed their classes, and they were great fun. My dad, I'd like to thank my dad, who always gave me time out of his day. My family was there to support me through all of this and continue to do so into my future. My oldest brother taught me to be persistent and keep up with what's going on out there in the world. So to my friends and family and staff, faculty here at the school, I say thank you. We have to keep going. There's much more for me out there in the world. And I'm prepared now to spread my wings as I go out into that world. Because I'm not done with my education. I hope to go to the Rochester Institute of Technology. And before I turn the stage over to the valedictorian for the class of 2016, I just would like to say, in sharing my story with you, I hope that it has somehow been an inspiration to you, an inspiration to the upcoming graduates for the coming years, as well as those graduating today. My story, I hope that it's been inspirational, somewhat motivational, and given you energy or has empowered you. Keep going. Don't stop. It's worth the laughter. Life is full of laughs. It's worth it. And humor is something that has always gotten me through, and it will help you as well. You know, there's a lot out there in the world that's negative. There's a lot going on out there. And I think sometimes, you know, it's easy to forget to laugh. And that laughter has always been important for me. And I love making other people laugh, and I hope that you all do that as well. To make the world a better place, a more positive place. So I suggest that you laugh away. Graduation is not the end. It's just the beginning of something new. So thank you all very much for letting me speak to you today. And I say farewell.
Hello, everyone. My name is Zacchaeus Walton, and I am the valedictorian of the class of 2016. I would like to congratulate the seniors who are graduating today. Great job. I'm thrilled to see everybody here, all the families, friends, staff members, faculty, everyone who's here. I just want to tell you that I really appreciate your attendance today. I'd like to share a little bit about my own background. I love to play sports. It doesn't matter what they are, I've always wanted to be involved in sports. I enjoy talking with people. I enjoy making friends, a variety of people. It's just always been something I want to do. And I'll tell you what, the Georgia School for the Deaf has been a very peaceful and beautiful place for me to be. I've enjoyed being here, and while here, I've learned a lot about the history of GSD, sports and academics and life in the dorm, and it's something that I've learned to really love and has made me very happy. I think it's... It's just been a critical time in my life being here. When I was young, I attended public school, and I found myself in special needs classes, and I experienced a lot of frustration because I didn't feel like I was learning much. I didn't feel like it was very much it had very much to offer me. And I was unhappy there. When I came to the School for the Deaf, I was just simply amazed because I didn't realize that there were that many deaf students. I didn't realize that there were deaf teachers. I didn't know I could interact and learn the way I could. And one thing I realized is that I could learn. I could do things. I could benefit from academics. You know, I was able to learn American Sign Language from friends face-to-face and improve my language skills. I learned about deaf culture and about ASL. And I've been so happy to be here. I've grown to love this school, and I've been very content and happy here. I hope to become an electrical engineer in the future. I intend to go to the Rochester Institute of Technology and earn my bachelor's degree and maybe even my master's. I want to be able to help families and friends and other people. I want to benefit the world so they can have a better life and a better future. So I encourage all GSD students, work hard, stay motivated, never give up. Do your best all the time in your classes, and remember, responsibility, resilience, and respect. That goes the same toward your teachers and towards each other. And I hope all of you will be successful. I know that you can be successful in your futures. Be confident in yourself. Believe in yourself. You can do anything. I want to thank my teachers, my friends, everybody who's been involved with my education for all of your support. You've taught me so much over the years. And you have been wonderful. I appreciate everyone being here. I love all you faculty and all you staff members. I just love everybody here. I will never forget my time here, never. I love the Georgia School for the Deaf. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, everyone. Hi. I have the great honor today to introduce our guest speaker. I'm just going to tell you a little bit about who he is. Some of you may know him, and some of you may not. But this gentleman did not learn how to read or write until he was 16 years old. He went into the Louisiana School for the Deaf when he was 16 years old. And it was there he learned, and he learned so quickly that he graduated within 3 years. So he graduated at 19 and continued on with his success in life. From there, he went to NTID, the National Technical Institute for the Deaf, in Rochester, New York, where Zacchaeus and David are planning on attending this fall. He was a student there, and he was the first black student, deaf student, president for one of the committees there at NTID. He was also the only deaf person to be voted president for the black deaf student government there, or for the black student government there. He got his bachelor's degree in social work from Gallaudet University. And today, there are only three people who are deaf and of color, who are black, who have that MSW, and he's one of them. He's currently Dean of Students at the Indiana School for the Deaf, and we used to have the honor of calling him our colleague here at the Georgia School for the Deaf. So I'm very honored to introduce to you today Mr. Tim Albert. Tim?
Thank you.
Hello, everyone. Well, what can I say? I am so very excited to be back here for this visit here in Cave Spring. And I honestly feel like I have this feeling of, you know, I have truly missed all of you. I really have. And I'll tell you why. I feel like I am part of the GSD family. My heart belongs here. And all I could say is, wow. You know, I was telling my wife, I get to come to Cave Spring, and she said, you do? Really? Oh, I miss them so much. I said, yes, I do too. I'm so happy to be able to come here. One person from this school invited me to come. Said, would you please come and speak at our graduation? And I said, absolutely. However, wait a minute. Let me just back up a minute. In 2006, I gave the commencement speech here. That's 10 years ago. That's unbelievable. It's been 10 years since I gave my last commencement speech here. And let me tell you, it is such an honor to come and take part in this celebration with the class of 2016. I truly do feel honored to be here with you guys today. So you've been talking about what an important milestone graduation is, and the milestones you're going to have throughout your life. So I've got some slides to share with you. I've got a bit of a story to tell, and I'm going to give you some advice as well, all right? So if you could please cue the slides. Can everybody see me all right? Next slide. Okay, here we are. All right, I have a question for all of you. Can you see this up here on the screen? So, would you like a good life for yourself? You want to be a good person? Would you like to have a nice car? Would you like to be able to buy a nice home for yourself? Would you like to have a nice family? Okay, so these are all things. You have great friends, right? You want great friends. You want to be able to take nice vacations for yourself. Everybody's saying, oh yeah, of course I do. Of course you do. Well, I would just like to share a bit of my story with all of you on how you can get these things. Okay? Look here. Yeah. That's right. That's me graduating from the Louisiana School for the Deaf. But you see what year I graduated? 91. That's right. Which means that's 25 years ago, folks. Wow. 25 years ago, I graduated from the Louisiana School for the Deaf. And again, I feel so honored to be here. And I'm looking back 25 years ago, I had my own graduation. This is really meaningful to me. So on graduation day, our class was so excited. It was graduation. And I'm pretty sure that you feel the same way that I did back in 91. So we were there at graduation, and everybody was wondering who our graduation speaker was going to be. None of us knew who it would be. Well, this gentleman came onto the stage. Now, remember, I like deaf people. I like hard of hearing people. I like hearing people, especially if they could sign, okay? But this gentleman came up on stage, and he couldn't sign. He required an interpreter. His name was Cleo Fields. Here's a photo of Mr. Fields. Okay, this was my commencement speaker at my graduation. Okay. So my friends were going, what's the deal? I said, hold on, let's just see what he has to say. Let's just listen to his story. So remember, he was up there on the platform speaking with an interpreter, and we watched the interpreter, and he gave his story, and his story absolutely touched my heart. And I've got to share that story with you today, okay? I don't have to. I gotta. I must, okay? And what he talked about was growing up in Louisiana, living with his family on a farm. They were very poor. They grew up very poor. However, he really had it in his mind that he wanted to go to school. He saw other students laughing at him because, you know, he had holes in his pants, in his knees. You know, he had a poor family, had holes in his shoes, all around the edges of his shoes. They came from just a poor family. And, you know, all that laughter and all that mocking, that hurt him. Of course, the people that mocked him were wrong. And honestly, I felt for him as I watched his story. But he maintained a positive attitude. He got through school. He went home, walked up to his mom, and he said, "Mom, you know, they're making fun of me at school." And his mom said, "You know what? You've got to keep a positive mindset. You've got to think positive." And he said, "But how can I do that, Mom?" And his mom said, "You've got to just keep on going. You've got goals you want to reach. You keep on going. You want to graduate, don't you?" And he said, "Yes." And he, now, back in this time, remember, they were very poor. He ate cheese sandwiches. He was a skinny little fella. But no matter what, he kept fighting. He kept going. He went to school, kept going to school, until he finally graduated, just like you're graduating today. He graduated, okay? Was that it? That was not it. He went on to college. He decided that he wanted to become a lawyer. That's right, a lawyer. So he went to college and he studied hard. He studied law. That was his big dream, his big goal. Law was his passion, and he kept at it. His mother was very proud of him. Now, you remember your parents, right? They're here. They're proud of you today. This is your special day. So anyway, Mr. Fields kept going until he graduated. A few days after graduation, he was selected to be a senator for the state of Louisiana. So he walked in and they had a new nice table for him there. Now, pay attention to this. He sat down at his shiny new table. Everything was laid out for him. It was perfect. It was fancy. It was beautiful. And the other senator from Louisiana walked in, walked up to him and said, "Hey." And he looked up and he said, "Yes." And he said, "Hey, do me a favor. Go get me a cup of coffee, will you?" And Cleo said, "Huh?" He thought, "Well, you know what? I should be nice. That's fine." So he stood up and he said, "Tell you what, I'm your friend. Let me introduce myself. My name's Cleo Fields. I'm a state senator. See that man over there? Can you please ask that gentleman to bring two cups of coffee for us?" Wow. Cleo Fields. He told his story, and I was blown away. So, you know, it doesn't matter if you're deaf, if you can sign, if you're hearing, if you could sign. It doesn't matter what. He came up, and he had a story to share. In that moment, his story affected my life. He never gave up. You never give up. So today, I'm going to give you some advice, all right? I've got some advice for you. What I've learned from Mr. Fields, and Mike, would you advance the slide, please? My graduation theme for you today, enter the cub. Little baby cub, that's right. You know, it doesn't matter how long you stay here. It doesn't matter whether you're here for several years or just a couple of years. When you get in here, you're just little cubs. Your mama has picked you up by the scruff of your neck and dropped you here at the School for the Deaf, okay? So you enter, and you're like a little tiger cub. You need to learn everything. And you know what? The Georgia School for the Deaf is the right place to drop your cubs. So you've entered a cub, but look at the second half. Exit the tiger. You've learned and you're ready to leave. So let's look at that enter the cub part first, okay? Here we go. All right. How many graduates do we have up here? How many tiger cubs do we have up here? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, right? 11. There are 11 of you, correct? So here you are up on day one. Folks, you remember dropping your cubs off at the front gate? They were ready to go, weren't they? So yeah, so here you are. It's nice to look back and see yourselves as cubs dropped off in front of the school, right? You entered the cubs. Next slide. Now, we've got some ABCs here. Now, I learned some ABCs from Cleo Fields, and I'm about to share those ABCs with you, okay, as part of the advice I have. A is for achiever. You've got to achieve in life. B, do your best. C, you can do it. Never say can't, you can, all right? You must perform deeds. You've got to be empowered. You've got to stay strong. Don't fear. Be empowered. You've got to have faith. You have talent. You've got to have faith in your own talents. Set goals. You've got to make plans and set goals and do it. Do your homework. Parents, don't help them. Make them do the homework themselves, right? Your resume is important. What is on your resume is going to be very important. You're going to give that to people in your life. Don't be jealous of what others have and what others do. Be yourselves. Don't be jealous of others. Keep going, no matter what. Keep going. Listen and learn. When you're in a discussion with your parents, listen. They've got good advice for you. They have things to say. Don't fight with them. Listen and learn. How do you find the path to motivation? Remain motivated. Be nice. Don't give sass. Don't give attitude. Be nice. All right? Y'all hear me? Think about your obligations. You've got work obligations. You've got car payments. Focus on your obligations. Remember, your life is precious. Don't be a quitter. Keep going. Keep working. Never quit. Read. Be a reader. You know that new car? You've got to read the paperwork to find out what's involved with it. You can't just glance over it and sign a paper to buy a car. You've got to read the details. See what that deal is all about. If you don't read the contract, if you can't read it, if you don't know what it says, get some help. Ask your parents. Read everything. Spirit. Keep your spirit about you, right? What we got next? You've witnessed my story, right? Saying that you must be proud. You must be tigers. You've seen me say this before, right? Sign this with me. Tigers. That's right. Tigers. You're tigers. And it's important to understand. Respect one another. Understand one another. Okay, look at this word right here. You know what this means? Oh, look at my watch. Look at my watch. You like my watch? You like my clothes? No, that's vainglory. Don't be like that. Be yourself, okay? Don't be vainglorious. There's a whole white world. Let me warn you about it. It's not always fun, but it helps to be prepared. It's important to have fun, have a good time, but you know the whole big wide world out there is scary. You've got to keep that in your mind. Think about the world. X-ray, okay? Study everything deeply. When you meet a new friend, study them deeply before you make any big mistakes. X-ray things before you bring them into your life. Be yourself. Be yourself. You know, out in the world, you can have a lot of fun. It's important to look back at the good times you had at the school, the football games, homecoming, your teachers, your friends, life in the dorm, your parents. It's important to remember all that. You know, you've graduated. You've got lots to look back on. This is graduation day. I'm sure everything's good. Be zealous about life. Okay, so here we go. Look. Now you're exiting as tigers. Goodbye. Let's hear it for these tigers up here. This is your exit. You're exiting as tigers. We are ushering you out the door. Your parents have great relief that you have learned the essential items of your education. You are now prepared to move on, to get out there into the world. And, you know, that's about all I'm going to say. But, you know, this is a lot of this I learned from Cleo. That stuck with me. And I wanted to share it with you. It's good advice. You know, I'm done. I'm going to be sitting down right over here. You're going to get your diplomas. I want to say congratulations to all of you. I wish you the best of luck. And thank you, everybody in attendance. Wow, thank you, Tim. Let's hear it for Tim one more time, everybody. Thank you so much. We next have a special song presentation by our Sign Design Choir here at GSD. Please come on up.
So big, and everything seems so out of reach. The sky is high, and the walk is wide. You just don't know what you've got yet. It's in the palm of your hands. It's right in front of where you stand.
Are you graduates ready? We have made it to the time. I don't know if you're ready. Are you sure you really want these diplomas? I'm not sure I want to give them to you. It's breaking my heart. Okay, let's begin then. Brianna Epiphany Burns. Anasia Monea Cooper. Myresha Shanice Grant. Sharika Vashana Hankins. Rakim Markel Johnson. David Martinez. Brianna Deschelle Smith. Javonta Edwin Smith. Desiree Kathleen Springer. Brianna Antoinette Thomas. Zykevius Deontay Walton. We now have a special video for all of you featuring each of our graduating seniors. So please enjoy.
fun times we had. I hope you smile and know that through the good and through the bad, I was on your side when nobody could hold us down. We claimed the brightest star and we came.
Class of 2016, please rise. And now, by the authority vested in me by the state of Georgia and Georgia's school superintendent, Mr. Richard Woods, I am proud to pronounce you graduates of the Georgia School for the Deaf. Please, oh, I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen, here are your graduating class of 2016. Let's hear it for them. Graduates, please turn your tassels.
Thank you.
And please feel free to join us for refreshments over in the cafeteria.